concert of this season. I'm going to say of the.
Tribute to kind of Lawrence Welk and kind of that sort of vibe there. before breaking into a tune called Duncan Johnston.
Oh. That's Duncan, not Boris.
Yeah. Let's be clear. We would have just broken Boris rather than... Oh, political joke, sorry. So yeah, then John kind of took it away there on a Irish jig / reel called the Raffle. I played a wee Irish tune that's not supposed to be able to be played on Scottish pipes.
Not by any mortal pipers, at least.
But I am neither mortal nor immortal. I exist somewhere in between. And then we finished off with a tune called The Wise Maid. And now we are going to do something different.
We're going to play some jigs for you now. This is a set of jigs that, one of which is the title of our last studio album. It's a tune written by John Bews over here in the fiddle called The Crossing. If you want to know what it looks like, you don't have to look far. It's right there. It was quite the adventure trying to learn it. To put him on a spinny chair and spin it around. Anyway. Funny business aside, we're going to start with a tune that I wrote called The Careful Jig. I have no idea why I called it that.
Well, by the number of kids he's got, I'd say it was rather misnamed. Sorry. He's only got one, so.
I promise to play it carefully. And we're going to end, so The Careful Jig, The Crossing, and then we'll end with a great old tune called Leslie's March. But it's a jig. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Your hands are going to hurt by the end of the night. I'm going to sing you a wee song now, just to, you know, show that we do have a sensitive side, and we have at least one feeling amongst us here. Although I'm not sure which one of us has it at the minute. This is a song by, I guess any of you remember the Incredible String Band? Okay, here we go. So this is, this is the part of the evening where we tune up. So there's a song by band leader, Mr. Robin Williamson. And alleged to be the first song that he ever composed. So I'm trying to do two things at once, and my brain is frying here. And we do this because, you know, it's completely seasonally inappropriate, and we like to be inappropriate. This is a wee song called October Song.
Thank you.
That's a tune. Thank you.
Oh yeah, that's right. There's a 20-second delay between. So for all of the, all of those of you out in the ether, we've already done this before. it's a weird Einsteinian relativity thing. Don't worry about it. It'll never happen again twice. All right, so we're gonna play a couple of tunes here that are. Well, the first one is from the island of Cape Breton. Do we have some Cape Bretoners in the audience?
No, just a huge fan.
Oh, okay, cool.
Fair enough. Us too.
So to drive home the import of this tune, I should fill you in on the concept of the Faish, which is a Gaelic festival. And basically, people get together and they speak Gaelic together and they play tunes in Gaelic and they drink in Gaelic and they fall over off their chairs and land on the floor in Gaelic and get up the next morning and do it again in Gaelic. And this particular Faish in question happened to have been graced by the presence of a rector, you know, a holy man. And so this fella, Ryan McNeil, who played a band called Gaelic, and he's one of the 420,583 Ryans McNeil from Cape Breton, and he's the 324th one of them who is a piper. So this tune is his responsibility. And then we'll play a tune that's very popular in Cape Breton and Ireland and Scotland and Pakistan and Madagascar, called Mullach na Cabba Féin in the Gaelic, or in praise of the deer's antlers, which were a symbol of the Mackenzies of Gerloch, and you know, it was supposed to be a big, you know, strong deer, manly, virile type of thing, because they're all, you know, into that kind of thing up there. Then we're going to play a tune called The Drunken Smith of Killychassy, and then we'll finish off with Farmer's Daughter.
Phrasing. Finish off with a tune called The Farmer's
Daughter.
write the happy Scottish song. And we've done it.
We found it.
This is a song that is it's an old Scots poem put to music by a man named Tony Cuff. Does anyone know Tony Cuff?
Yeah.
A few of you. Yeah, so Tony Cuff, for those of you who don't know, was an incredible singer and guitarist. Passed away about a little over 20 years ago now. Spent the last decade or two of his life in Massachusetts, where I grew up. I grew up in Medford. He spent his time in Arlington, right next to where I grew up. I never met him, but he left his mark. And I came to the music too late, but when I came, there was a trove of his, and I've dug through it and appreciated it, and he's become quite a hero. He was a singer and guitarist in the band Ossian, which was a very influential Scottish band, and was known for writing his own songs as well as interpreting traditional songs. So this is a poem he put to music. I'm sometimes known as a walking Tony Cuff cover band, so we'll call this the first Tony Cuff song of the evening. Has a great chorus. Does that mean anything to you?
Yes!
Okay. Do you want to learn it?
Yes.
All right, repeat after me. Say will we yet.
Say will we yet.
That's it. That's all you need to know. So it goes, say will we yet, say will we yet. You repeat the last line of whatever verse came before, and then say will we yet. Now the verses are in Scots. If you speak Scots, wonderful. And if you don't, blah, 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 just anything to get through, it's gonna work out great, I promise. Sounds like this. And say will we yet, and say will we yet. La da 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 da. And say will we yet. Together? And say will we yet, and say will we yet. La da 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 da. And say will we yet. Yes. Fabulous.
Oh, you just get you guys to do the song. Just sit here and have a listen.
I had a feeling you guys would be a singing crowd. Here it is. Say where we at. Three, four.
Set and then we're going to take a big break, recharge our water glasses here and, let you guys stand up, get some oxygen back to your buttocks, and then in about 10 minutes we'll be back to do some more of this. So, to finish off here, we'll play a wee Irish tune called The Musical Beast.
I think it was a priest, actually.
Priest, yeah, musical priest. I always get that one mixed up. John's going to rip into a tune by Aidan O'Rourke.
Yep.
Called Ways of Rush. Then I will give you a wee sampling of some light classical Highland pipe reels, which is called Alex C. McGregor. And then I'm going to play this tune by, for those of you who are familiar with the whole Scottish music, canon, whatever it's called. I've heard of this fellow by the name of Angus Grant, who sadly passed away a few years ago. This is one of his tunes that he composed after being slobbered on by one too many drunk tourists at Hogmanay in Edinburgh. And it's a tune called The Whiskey Kiss.
Thank you.
Renzo, Renzo, it's just like them pretty girls when they gets the notion. Renzo, Renzo, so, I got your attention. Normally I tell you about the upcoming concerts, and I can tell you though, in the fall we're going to have a fabulous group from Quebec, Ate, who we're actually going to be at the festival as well. We're going to have Matthew Byrne from Newfoundland, and Nick Garris, who is an amazing percussive dancer, is going to be joined by Allison DeGroot, who is a wonderful, wonderful banjo player. So look for those things happening in next fall, and there's more coming. Myra Nehahasig and Chris Newman will be back. This is some of the preview of the year ahead. But the most important thing, coming up in just a little over, about 5 weeks, the festival. Live and in person. So we have these wonderful cards that if you're on the mailing list, you probably got them in the mail, or you're getting them in the mail. And if you'd like to take some more and spread the word, feel free. And if you haven't gotten one, feel free to take one on your way out. But we also are looking for some volunteers for the festival. So anyone here who'd like to volunteer, we'd love to have you. And you in Streamland, come on out and volunteer for the festival. Go online to oldsongs.org and you can see all about it. Now that I've talked too much, I'm going to ask Cantrip. I'm going to try not to trip going down the stairs. Cantrip. No. Yeah. Okay. So without further ado, part two, Cantrip.
Thank you.
First one, is the rather odd title of Zito the Bubble Man, which was composed by probably one of the true geniuses of the last century on the bagpipes, fellow by the name of Gordon Duncan. Who's known? And he used to, he played for a while with the Tannehill Weavers, and this tune came about where he was playing at a festival not too far from here, the name of which I don't know, but they got, the band got there and, you know, it was a bit like that scene from Spinal Tap where the band shows up and they've been billed after the puppet show. Tannies have been billed after this fella by the name of Zito the Bubble Man. And so while the rest of the band kind of waddled off to the beer tent in disgust, you know, Gordon went to kind of have a look at what this, you know, what this guy was all about. And apparently this fella would, his act was he would blow these gigantic soap bubbles and like climb inside them somehow and do stuff in there, like, you know, ride a bike or do his taxes or something like that. And Gordon was so impressed by this that he composed that tune. I played a Rudy Campbell tune called Opinions One, and a tune that we always thought was trad, and we always thought it was called Kitty Kelly's, but then started finding out it was also called like Mary Kelly's and Ned Kelly's and Dr. David Kelly's and all this kind of thing. Turns out it's a Tommy Peoples tune. If those of you remember him. So now we'll play some actual full on jigs.
Irish ones are that.
Irish ones are that, yeah. Yeah. There's a tune, we start out with a tune called Felix the Greased Up Greco Roman Wrestler. Which is a little bit odd as titles go. It's also known as Biddy from Sligo in some parts of Ireland. And the two may be the same person, but we're not really sure. A tune called Siobhan O'Donnell's Number Two and The Choice Wife.
Thank you.
a set that was on our first album, which came out, Jesus, over 20 years ago now. And it was a CD that we recorded with a record company, and somehow in the contract they retained the rights to the recording, even though we had the rights to the music. So since we could no longer get it, some years ago we decided to re-record the whole thing live in front of a studio audience. And thus we have the Cantrip live CD over here, which I realised the selection looks a bit dodgy in terms of CDs themselves, but we have produced more than one. I also realised, when I was smack talking Eric before, in that comment about his one kid, that's actually a little bit of a lie. Amongst the three of us up on stage here, we actually have collectively about 15 babies at home to support. And that a few of them are not exactly sure whose is whose. But they just kind of, float around house to house. It's all fine. But the real point here is that, if you were interested in, buying CDs or, grabbing one of those cards and, sort of helping to pre-fund the next CD, you would in fact be saving babies' lives. So, do your part.
With that, we will sing you a song. This is a song called Bra Sailing. Bra, B-R-A-W, it's a Scots word for anything that's good or exciting. This is a very typical Scottish love song, which starts out with all the right makings of a happy song and very quickly stops trying and ends, not surprisingly, with a lad in a pub, brokenhearted. So,
sobbing into his pint.
Here it is, Bra Sailing.
Chickens, if you put them too close together, they start picking the feathers off each other. And, but we're going to give it a go. So this is a song that comes from the Isle of North Uist, which, for those of you unaware of Scottish geography, is kind of one of the northwesternmost chunks of rock that sticks out of the North Atlantic, and. Happens to be home to a lot of the McDonald's. In fact, it's the land of Eric's forefathers.
All four of them.
It's kind of a complicated family situation there. But so the story behind this song it starts back in about 1457, and ends a day later. There were a bunch of MacLeods from the Isle of Harris, which is to the north there, who came over to North Uist for a visit and to acquire some cattle. Now, the McDonalds of the area didn't really jive to this idea. So they got together a posse, you know, to use the parlance of our times, and basically just went and kicked nine colours of snot out of the McLeods and sent the leftovers packing it back to Harris. But in the meantime, the young chief of the McDonalds managed to get himself shot in the side with an arrow, which by the look of you, I'd say, you know, understand that that's a, you know, fairly painful experience. So he was dragged, you know, kicking and screaming off the battlefield to a black house where his foster mother and various others, you know, attempted to, you know, put him back together and, you know, pick the shrapnel out of his ribcage and all that kind of thing.
And shrapnel is impressive from an arrow. I have to say.
The weapons technology up there was unbelievable. So the song, the song talks about, you know, what a fab fella he is and how crud the world would be if he ever went away. And there's some bits where it talks about some of the Hebridean medical practices at the time, which, you know, if you're at all familiar with what they do to cloth, you just sort of extrapolate that to the human body, and that's probably what they were doing at this poor lad. Anyway, I'm going to shut up and sing. There's a song called Avichian Chemish in the Gaelic, which means son of James, son of John. Here we go. Okay.
very much.
I started singing that and thinking, this feels really high.
Yes, that's because it was.
I set the capo at the wrong spot, so I'm going to step up from where I normally do that. So I'm just, in your imagination, just kind of pitch shift it.
That was easy for me. I just moved my capo up too. John here got in from Edinburgh at midnight last night. And then Dan's just trying to throw
that helped, actually. It's also probably worth pointing out that song was in Gaelic. It's all right, you're not drunk. you might be. We're not here to judge. But it was not intended to be understood unless you speak the Gaelic. That's all I'm saying. Now, we have, from time to time, been accused of playing Scottish and Irish music. This is perhaps not 100% unfair. However, we do other things. And the first tune in this set is Case in Point. It's a Romanian tune. It's a tune called Podoloi Hora. Now, I have no idea what Podoloi Hora means. I know nobody that speaks Romanian. I do know that Bulgarians have a dance called a horo, and Romania is not a million miles from Bulgaria, so it may potentially be a dance of some kind that's in some way related. So I'm going to go ahead and say it's a dance from Romania called a horo. It's Podoloi's dance of that description. And we follow that with, in the only realistic way you can, with a Fraser Fifield tune from the Highlands piping / saxophone tradition called Glen Cabol. And then we go a little more traditional for the last two, the Ale is Dear and Androchich Kuchich, which is Gaelic again.
You can think of this set as sort of like Count Dracula meets Osama bin Laden, runs over Mark Zuckerberg, throws it in reverse to finish the job, and then.
I mean, you could. It's true.
My mother did once tell me that I didn't have to say everything that came into my mind. She might have been right.
She also told you should listen to her.
And then I became a musician.
So we like to call this set the weird set.
Thank you.
very much indeed. Thank you. So I now plan to sing you a song that is only 50% old. Is that okay? That's all right. Okay, crap. The tune for this is old. The words are really quite new by comparison. It's an affectionate parody of an old song. The original song is called "Cauld Blow the Windy Night," the subject matter of which concerns a knight who is out travelling and gets caught in a storm, sees the lonesome farmer's house up on the hillside there, light burning in the window, goes and knocks on the door. The farmer's daughter lets him in. Long story short, no good comes of it. I'm not going to sing you that song because that's filth. The song I am going to sing you, in fairness, is also filth, but is funnier. It's a new set of words written by the marvellous Sid Kipper of the Kipper family. That's fancy. That is the first time anybody has ever recognised that name. They're marvellous. I love the Kippers. It's Sid Kipper's words set to an older version of the melody. This version is called "Old Whaley Windy Night." My head is frozen to my hat. The snow is drifting down my back. Sir Jasper.
Tune that we played at the end there was actually composed by a fellow who used to be in the band by the name of Gavin Marwick, which was appropriately or inappropriately, depending on how you look at it, titled "The Old Wood." Now, unfortunately, we're kind of at that point in the evening where we're going to play one more set of tunes and then we're going to stop and we're going to go somewhere else and do something else. Sadly, I'm assuming that you probably will too. I believe the doors close about a half an hour after we finish, something like that. But before we continue on with this, I'd like to give a huge round of applause to Joy and Chris for getting us in here and organising this whole thing and making it happen. So, yes! And a big thank you to all of you for coming out and getting the crack with us. You've been a fantastic audience. I don't know how you've kept the energy up, but you have. Here's to you. So for you lot here, we're gonna play one more set. For those of you in the interweb land, the gig is already finished. you're getting this way. We'll go out much the way we came in. We'll start with a tune called "The Lambing Storm" by a shepherd fellow from up in Easter Ross, Dagger Gordon. It's assumed that this is a tune about a storm that occurred during lambing season and not about sheep falling out of the sky. We'll follow that with a Brendan McGlinchey tune called "The Splendid Isolation," which is very apropos after the last couple of years. The next tune is by a relatively obscure fiddle player from, I think originally he's from up in Inverness somewhere, but now stays in California. This fellow by the name of Alistair Fraser. You can applaud. He's well worth the trouble. Tune called the Skye Barbecue, which again we assume is about a barbecue that happened on Skye, and it's not, you know, a commentary on the socio-political history of that island over the last 300 years. And then we'll finish off with what, in my humble and perhaps semi-professional opinion, is the sexiest, most pelvic gyrating tune ever to come out of the Highland piping tradition. A tune called the Lena Mackay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
us for punishment, so yeah.
Just want to say, I hope you all come to the festival in June. And thank you all to everyone here, everyone at Old Scots, for keeping this going. It's been how many years now?
Festival since 1981.
1981.
That's
a long
years.
Time. That's older than me, so. Good on y'all, and it's a real honor to be here playing for y'all, so thank you for coming out. We really appreciate you. We're gonna go out with a tune that, the set that we take our name from, it's called the Cantrip set. Thank you.
and hope to see you at the festival. Hope to see you at concerts again in the fall. And many hands make light work. If you can take your chair and take it to this side, to that side, that side, to this side. Anyway, thank you again for coming. Get home safe.